candid. Like, I don't want to throw anybody under the bus or throw any shade to other organizations. But there's been a lot of shady business in esports. There's been a lot of shady business in esports. I'm sure you've covered it. I'm sure you've seen it. Where, you know, people that own certain things or orgs or whatever it is, they fudge some numbers, they make up some things, or they just use numbers that they accrue numbers worldwide to present to investors. And investors get excited about all these eyeballs or this money that they could technically make from endemic sponsors from the space. And they kind of just throw money at certain orgs or whatever it is. But those numbers don't, if you look at where the views come from, most of them come from Korea, from China. Like they're coming from over there. We don't have like real, legitimate, tangible numbers here that can be translated to real, tangible dollar bills. So they are being smart here with the way they're playing it. They're partnering with people that they trust. In Chris Overholt and Overactive Media, especially here at Bell. So I'm happy that they're just taking their time with it. And slowly I will introduce them to other esports. And like my goal, honestly, is to get to somehow get a partnership with Psyonix. And let's do like a broadcast with Rocket League, because I feel like Rocket League is the esport. Like Rocket League is the esport to bridge the gap here and kind of meld these two worlds. And because it's so easy to understand. It's so easy for people that watch sports to understand what's happening in Rocket League. It's not a MOBA. It's not like a crazy shooter that they need to follow. Also, it's so G-rated that they can sell to any kind of sponsor. So,
and they're doing a good job of integrating sponsors into the game with skins and different maps and things.
Oh yeah. So, slowly but surely we'll get there. Also, like I have a soft spot for Rocket League. I love hosting Rocket League tournaments. I freaking love Brody Moore, LeafX, who as a co-host of mine on a television show that I was hosting here in Canada called Squad and Heads Up Daily. He is just so freaking talented and I love seeing that kid shine. Just any way to like work with that broadcast team as well is exciting to me. I just think there's so many talented people in esports and I would love for the sports world to see it. And I feel like it's easier now too for us to bridge the gap a little bit because there's so many athletes getting involved in esports. For us here in Toronto, we have a player that plays for the Maple Leafs, Zach Hyman, who started an esports org here called E11. And he it's mostly for Fortnite kids or Fortnite streamers or whatever it is, he's backing that. But I just like that because we pay so much attention to hockey and the Leafs, and a Leaf player is now invested in esports and likes talking about it, is a big deal here. It does transit. These people make their mark and these words do go far.